Hello and welcome to this morning's video. It is now 5:22 in the morning. It's the day after we picked the load up in Roanoke, and now we're sitting in Pennsylvania near York, PA. If you're looking for where that's at, that's not too far from Harrisburg, PA. But we're sitting in the dock door and we're waiting for that little red light to turn back green. They're unloading the load already, which is pretty good because the appointment wasn't until 6 and we're ahead of schedule in the dock door getting unloaded, so that's a good deal. Got another truck coming in over here, so we got first spot this morning, or at least the truck's arriving here, which is a good thing. So before everybody else gets here, hopefully we will be done, have our paperwork signed, and be headed back down the road. So a little cloudy this morning up here. Not bad. Temperature's still pretty good. And was going to look and see if we could grab a backhaul load on the way back. We've got some other business to come up that we need to take care of, some personal things. So we're not going to worry about a backhaul today. We're just going to scoot on back to Stephen City and be done with it. So as soon as they get everything off of here, we'll be headed back up to Howie. I'm hoping that by the time that we leave, that we'll miss some of the morning traffic. Maybe not. We're a little ahead of schedule, so we might get caught in some of the morning traffic. But that's all right. It is what it is. Not a big deal. One of the things that you already know if you're in trucking, and if you're not, if you're thinking about getting into trucking, is that you have to be able to get your butt up at whatever hour of the day it needs to be to make things happen. I think this morning I got up about 2 o'clock, maybe a little bit before that. And of course, it didn't run right out the door. Got up, had coffee, and did my other routine stuff. Then I had to come get the truck, pre-trip the truck, make sure everything's in order, get it warmed up. And update the electronic devices, electronic logs and navigation stuff, get all that stuff taken care of, and then get in the wind and get headed up here. And it's gonna be like that sometimes. Sometimes you're gonna be picking up or delivering in the middle of the day, sometimes you're gonna be picking up and delivering in the wee hours of the morning, or sometimes you have to get up in the wee hours of the morning to go make a delivery, which was the case with this load. Yesterday we picked this up in Roanoke, took it back to the drop lot, sat on it overnight, and then it had to be up here by 6 o'clock in the morning. And when you're coming into areas or through areas that have a lot of traffic, you have to be particularly cognizant of that. If you think you're gonna roll in somewhere at the last 5 minutes, good luck with that. You're gonna be under stress and late most of the time. The old saying I like that I have said for years and used to teach people, and that is, early is on time and on time is late. That's particularly true in trucking. There are a lot of folks that try to drive a tractor trailer like they're driving a Miata or some other kind of little car, and think that they're gonna scoot into places like they're running an errand across town. Doesn't work like that. You have to, my general target for me is I like to try to target being at the pickup or the delivery 1 hour early. If I hit traffic or backups and that kind of stuff, gives me a little bit of a fudge factor. And also, the longer the trip that you make, the more fudge factor you're gonna have to build into it. There's more opportunities for more traffic delays or backups or road shut down due to somebody else causing an accident or whatever. If you built in some time to it, you're still probably gonna be able to make your pickups and your deliveries on time most of the time without a problem. But if you're running just barely enough time to make it, all those things are gonna knock you out of schedule, and you're gonna be late for your pickups and deliveries, and that's not a good thing. Not a good thing for your reputation, not a good thing for your time management. You show up late to an appointment, a lot of times they're gonna move you to the back of the line, and you're gonna wind up sitting there all day if you get unloaded that day at all. So, again, you're just gonna have to be able to get up whatever hour of the day is required. You know, sometimes it's 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. You know, sometimes it's later in the day. But good thing about this is that by the time that I get back and get done with everything, it'll only be about the middle of the day. So I still have the rest of the day to do whatever else I need to do or want to do. One of those things probably going to be take a nap. But adventures in trucking. Yeah, this is a pretty good load. Like I said, it's relatively light. This is the second time I think I've been to this place. I don't know why, but when you come in this particular place, they always try to send you around to the wrong side of the building. They give you the door number you need to go into, which is on this side, but they keep telling you it's on the other side. So I don't know if there's security offices in some other location. They just don't know, you know, what's what. Another place I go to is a food line. I pick up pallets a lot of time. Food line distribution center. They will routinely at the gate tell you to go to a specific door in a specific building. That's the wrong place. And you're going to stand around over there waiting for somebody to talk to. And when they finally come out and talk to you, they're going to say, oh, you need to go up to this other building and go in a side door and check in there. Now, I know that. So when the gate guard tells me to go to the wrong place, I just say, okay. And I don't. I go to the place I know I'm supposed to be. But, you know, until you figure those things out, if it's customers that you're going to on again and again, you can learn those little sort of tricks and, you know, where you need to be, and who you need to see and that kind of stuff. If you're doing OTR stuff or you're not going to the same places routinely, you have to kind of like games and puzzles in trucking, because a lot of times that's what it's like. You have to figure out how to get into place to start with. Sometimes that's a big enough trick. A lot of places have multiple entrances. Some of them are for trucks, some of them aren't. Some of them are the ones for you, some of them are for other trucks. Some of them exit a different gate. Like for example, Dollar General in South Boston, you come in one gate, and then when it's time to leave, you leave out the gate on the other side of the parking lot. It's not real well marked or real well explained to people, so they're constantly trying to go in and out the wrong places. But again, it's just part of trucking, things you got to learn and deal with, and not let it fluster you. If you get flustered easily, trucking is probably not the right game for you. A lot of things like that. On the other hand, you know, like I said, you like figuring out puzzles, you might like it. Talked to a lot of people in my travels. Talked to a guy yesterday. As a matter of fact, we picked this up. It's a friend of his, owner-operator. He's kind of interested in getting into trucking, so I explained him some basics about getting into it as a company driver and also what it takes to get started as an owner-operator. And one of the biggest things I would say, regardless of whether you're trying to get started in trucking as a company driver, as a leased-owned owner-operator, as an independent owner-operator, or you're trying to get started in something else. Let's say you want to get into an online business. You want to start an affiliate marketing business of your own. Or you want to start some other kind of digital marketing or print-on-demand products or anything you can think of. Whatever it is that you want to do, one of the first things that you want to do is gather information. Do research. Find out the basic fundamentals of it. And then start getting enough information to make your initial decisions that either yes, this is something you want to pursue, or no, it's not for you. If it is, then there's different levels of information that you're going to need to do your homework and research on, so that you can actually start taking action and get started making progress toward reaching whatever goals you set for yourself. Trucking is certainly one of those things. A lot of people only talk to trucking recruiters. And that's a decent place to start in getting information, but you need to understand recruiters are salespeople. Some are better than others. Some are more honest than others. Even the good ones are always going to accentuate the positive and probably downplay the negative. So you want to get your information from multiple sources, not just the salespeople trying to sell you whatever it is that you're interested in getting into, whether that's trucking or some affiliate marketing course or membership or book or event or whatever, anything. It doesn't matter. You know, real estate agent, real estate investing, making physical products and selling it. If you're interested in getting through some type of product that's going to help you make those things, or some type of course that's going to help you learn how to do those things, always gather your information from multiple sources, weigh it and evaluate it so that you can make better informed decisions and hopefully get better results on what it is that you set out to do. So, I already have a number of courses on Udemy. I mention that all the time, but that's one of the main sources of income for our company. And we have multiple income production opportunities and multiple sources of income, multiple different ways we make money. One of them, of course, is delivering freight, you know, picking up and transporting and delivering freight itself. Hope to be adding other drivers and building it into a fleet so we have other owner-operators leased on, and eventually probably some company drivers too working for the company and delivering freight. But we also make money with courses, online courses. I have made money with events, consulting, and things of that nature in the past, and we'll be doing some more of that in the future, working with individuals and small groups to teach people what's necessary to start a trucking company and get all the DOT compliance stuff set up and get their business management control systems in place. And also teach a lot of courses on general business and entrepreneurship for people that are interested in starting an online business or some other type company, the fundamentals of what's necessary in order to make that happen. So, you know, information we put out primarily is in online courses right now, in ebooks and books and some training manuals and other publications, as well as going to be putting out more and more YouTube videos that are sort of tutorials, not just vlog type stuff, but actual how to do stuff in snippets. A course and a video are similar but not exactly the same thing. A course is a series of sequential videos that all work together and are aligned, and then there's usually other resources in that too. There's written information in it, there's quizzes and tests, other list of resources, so it's a much more formalized sequential way of studying something, whereas a tutorial is just a snippet or a little bit of information on a particular topic. You know, but it's a good place to start, and it's also a good supplemental resource to the other resources, such as courses and books and ebooks and training manuals and that kind of stuff. So, I guess that'll about do it. Just a quick early morning video to say hello and tell you where I'm at. Yeah, as I said, I'm just outside of York, Pennsylvania. It should be empty here now. I don't know if you can see the truck rocking around or not, but they're actively unloading it. I think they're about half done already. And as soon as they get done, we'll be headed back out that gate, back out onto the interstate, back toward the yard and the house. And I'll probably make another video of some type in the next day or two. But until then, take care, be safe, and I'll talk to you again soon in the next video.